All right, folks, let's dive right into the latest buzz around Prince Harry and Meghan's royal status. It seems like the topic is hotter than ever, especially with certain commentators stirring the pot. Kizzy's co-filled, for instance, has been suggesting that Archie and Lily bet Diana might be Harry and Meghan's ticket back into the royal inner circle. But here's the thing. When Harry speaks, it's like a game of telephone with the media and so-called experts. They often twist his words to suit their own storylines. Remember that interview Harry did with Alison Cooper last year? When asked about returning to the royal family as a full-time member, Harry's answer was a firm no. Yet, despite his clear stance, folks like Kizzy's co-filled are still speculating on his return. What's even more intriguing is how these commentators seem to be shaping their own narratives. Despite having access to all of Harry's interviews, they're still spinning tales that veer off from his actual words. It makes you wonder, doesn't it? And get this, Kizzy's co-filled once photoshopped herself into Harry and Meghan's engagement. Photos, if someone's going to that length, how credible can they really be as a source on all things Harry and Meghan? It's a wild world out there, and it seems like the saga of Harry, Meghan, and the royal family is far from over. Stay tuned, because this story is definitely not going anywhere anytime soon. Now, let's turn our attention to Hollywood. Surprisingly, American media outlets don't seem to give much credence to Kizzy's co-filled when it comes to all things Harry and Meghan, yet it's a different story in the UK, where she seems to have a platform despite her questionable antics. Remember the time she photoshopped her face onto Meghan's in the engagement photos? That's some next-level fan fiction. In my opinion, Kizzy's co-filled might be more suited for a mental institution than a TV studio. I mean, if she ever got within a 100 meters of Harry and Meghan, someone should probably call the police. Now, let's talk about Kelly, another self-proclaimed expert. Kelly seems to think there's a way back for Prince Harry into the royal family, but Meghan, not a chance. It appears the UK media and certain royal insiders aren't too keen on Meghan returning to the fold. But they do keep spinning this narrative that Harry might use his kids as his ticket back in. And then there's the drama surrounding Frogmore Cottage. Rumors are swirling about what Harry supposedly said to Charles. Something along the lines of, "Don't you want to see your grandkids anymore?" But really, who knows what was actually said? The truth is often lost in the whirlwind of royal gossip. Stay tuned as this royal roller coaster shows no signs of stopping. So the big question remains, what exactly did Harry say to Charles? Honestly, we don't know for sure, but let's focus on what we do know. Harry and Meghan have been fiercely protective of their children, Archie and Lilibet Diana. They've been shielding them not just from the relentless UK press, but also from some senior members of the royal family, who, let's not forget, have faced allegations of making racist remarks about Archie, even before he was born. It's been suggested that Charles and Kim Wooten were the ones who had those conversations about Archie's skin color. Imagine the pain and frustration Harry and Meghan must have felt as parents dealing with racism within their own family. Their response? To put a fortress around their kids. The UK press, on the other hand, seems to have a different agenda. They appear to be itching for unrestricted access to Archie and Lilibet, maybe to spin more stories, or worse, to monetize their images. But Harry and Meghan's move to Montecito has thrown a wrench in those plans. The couple's commitment to their children's privacy is, frankly, quite remarkable. We rarely catch a glimpse of Archie or Lilibet, and on the off chance a paparazzo snaps a photo, it's usually blurred to protect their identity. This level of privacy is a stark contrast to what the UK media seems to want. Remember the intense scrutiny Harry and William faced after Diana's passing? Harry and Meghan are clearly determined to write a different story for their children. They're not just celebrities or royals, they're parents first, fiercely guarding their little ones from the public eye. Stay tuned, because this story of privacy, protection, and parenting in the public eye is far from over. Now, let's turn back the clock to a pivotal moment in royal history. After Diana's tragic passing, the public's resentment towards Charles was palpable. His image took a significant hit due to the perception of how he treated Diana. In a bid to salvage his reputation, Charles allowed the media limited access to Harry and William, but with strings attached. This move was seen as an attempt to garner positive press for himself, using his sons in the process. The most poignant and heart-wrenching moment was when young Harry and William were made to walk behind their mother's coffin. It was a strategy by the royal family to evoke public sympathy, despite their cold treatment of Diana. This act, which was especially hard on Harry, drew even more public attention and sympathy towards the young princes. The media, which played a significant role in hounding Diana, shockingly began to refer to Harry as the new Diana after her death. This label highlighted their intention to exploit Harry in a similar fashion. Now, fast forward to today, and it seems they're eyeing Archie and Lilibet Diana with the same exploitative mindset. The UK tabloid press appears eager for Harry to present his children for their profit-driven narratives. It's important to note that Archie and Lilibet are indeed prince and princess. Harry's recent efforts to secure his family's safety in America, while also wanting his children to understand their heritage, are completely justified. However, he's not advocating for the UK media to have unfettered access to his family. Harry's focus seems to be on ensuring that his children appreciate their lineage without falling prey to media exploitation. The complexities of royal life, privacy, and media scrutiny continue to unfold in the lives of Harry and Meghan and their children. Stay with us as we navigate through these ongoing royal dynamics. Let's dissect Harry's intentions for his kids a bit more, shall we? Harry's expressed a desire for Archie and Lilibet Diana to understand their heritage, emphasizing the UK's role in it. He envisions a safe environment for his family during their visits to the UK. This is a reasonable expectation, right? But somehow, this gets twisted into the notion that Harry wants to hand over his kids to the UK media or certain public figures. Let's be clear. Harry never said he wants his kids to be familiar with Kenzie Schofield, Piers Morgan, or Patrick Christie's. These commentators seem to be reading way too much into Harry's words, almost desperate for any kind of access to Archie and Lilibet Diana. It's a bit much, honestly. And then, there's this wild idea floating around that Harry should use his kids to reconnect with the royal family, almost as a bargaining chip. Patrick Christie's. Even suggested appealing to Charles's emotions using the grandkids. Think about it. On one side, there's this narrative pushing Harry to exploit his children, to mend fences with the royal family, echoing what some believe Charles did with Harry and William after Diana's death. The implication. Here is that Harry should follow in those footsteps for the sake of rejoining the royal fold, but that's not who Harry has shown himself to be. He's been very protective of his children's privacy and well-being, contrary to what some media pundits are advocating. The situation is complex, and there are no easy answers. The intersection of family, media, and royalty often creates a convoluted narrative. But one thing seems clear. Harry's priority is the welfare and privacy of his children, not using them as pawns in a royal game. Stick with us as this intriguing story of heritage, family, and media continues to unfold. Now, let's address this tangled web of speculation about Harry's intentions. Just because Harry asked Charles if he didn't want to see his grandkids anymore doesn't automatically mean he's plotting a royal comeback. It's not that straightforward. Here's my take on the situation. The UK media and certain so-called experts have been relentless in their calls for Harry and Meghan to give up their titles. It's like they're pushing for Harry to renounce his birthright. This reminds me of the biblical story of Esau and Jacob, where Esau gave up his birthright to Jacob. In the story, Jacob then becomes the chosen one, receiving blessings and good fortune. Similarly, some in the UK media seem to want Harry to forfeit his birthright. In this case, the Duke of Sussex title. The underlying issue here seems to be the media's frustration with Harry. They're irked because he's standing up to his perceived abusers, suing the UK tabloid press, and, let's not forget, marrying a woman of color and staunchly defending her. To some in the media, these actions are seen almost as a crime, and they believe Harry should be punished by losing his title. But let's be clear, no one should be stripped of their birthright. This title, Duke of Sussex, is a part of Harry's identity and heritage. And about their kids being titled Prince and Princess, well, it's a part of their heritage too. It's not just about titles, it's about identity, legacy, and family history. The dynamics here are complex and multi-layered, involving issues of family, identity, media influence, and public perception. We're witnessing a modern saga that intertwines ancient traditions with contemporary challenges. Keep watching this space as we continue to explore the unfolding story of Harry, Meghan, and their relationship with both the royal family and the media. Let's delve into the birthright and titles of Archie and Lilibet. It's a matter of royal protocol that the grandchildren of the monarch are entitled to be styled as prince and princess. So when Queen Elizabeth passed away and Charles ascended the throne, Archie and Lilibet were supposed to be immediately recognized as prince and princess. However, it didn't happen right away. It was only after Harry and Meghan claimed this birthright for their children that they were officially styled as such, notably during Lilibet's christening. What's intriguing here is the idea of choice. It seems Harry and Meghan want to leave the decision of whether to use these titles up to Archie and Lilibet when they're older. But it's also crucial to acknowledge that no one should be pressured to relinquish their birthright. It belongs to them. Harry, as the Duke of Sussex, and Meghan, by marriage, the Duchess of Sussex, have these titles as part of their identity. The real issue seems to be with Meghan holding a royal title. There's a noticeable undercurrent of discomfort among certain groups because Meghan, a woman of color, is a duchess and, in a sense, a princess. I even came across a troll recently claiming Meghan is not a princess, but let's set the record straight, she is. This is evident even on Archie and Lilibet's birth certificates. The controversy surrounding Meghan's royal status reveals deeper issues of bias and acceptance. It's not just about titles. It's about what those titles represent and who is deemed worthy of them. This ongoing debate over birthrights, titles, and the intersection with race and heritage continues to be a focal point in discussions about the royal family. As we watch this saga unfold, it's important to keep these broader societal contexts in mind. Stay tuned for more insights as we navigate through these complex royal narratives. No matter the opinions of trolls or those harboring racist views, Meghan's status as a princess remains a fact. The core issue for many critics isn't Harry's title, but rather that Meghan, a biracial woman, is addressed as the Duchess of Sussex. This reveals deep-seated biases and a reluctance to accept her royal status, which is problematic and reflective of broader societal issues. Harry and Meghan are adamant about not surrendering their children to the whims of the UK tabloid press, contrary to what some might expect. They desire, above all, happiness for Archie and Lilibet. They're determined to prevent their children from becoming scapegoats or pawns in a media-driven narrative that pits them against their cousins, William and Kate's children. The media seems eager for this kind of rivalry, but Harry and Meghan are steering clear of that path. Harry noted in his memoirs that the UK tabloid press thrives on conflict within the royal family. This is a key point to remember when we hear claims of insider information about Archie and Lilibet. Harry and Meghan are fiercely protective of their children's privacy to avoid exactly this kind of media exploitation, where the press claims intimate knowledge of their children's personalities and lives. This is not just about shielding Archie and Lilibet from the public eye. It's about protecting their right to a normal childhood, free from the narratives and characterizations concocted by the media. Harry and Meghan's stance is a strong one. They don't want anyone claiming they know their children's characters or personal lives. This level of privacy is a shield against the invasive and often damaging tactics of the tabloid press. As this narrative unfolds, it's crucial to understand the various factors at play: media dynamics, privacy concerns, and the impact of race and heritage on public perception, stay tuned as we continue to explore the evolving story of Harry, Meghan, and their family. Remember why the smear campaign against Meghan Markle hasn't taken the hold that some hoped it would? A lot of it comes down to Meghan's past, her achievements, and her successful life. This background has played a crucial role in undermining the efforts to tarnish her reputation. When the royal family and the UK media attempted to paint Meghan as a bully, it backfired. Why? Because people who have actually worked with Meghan stepped forward to defend her. Take the Suits cast, for example. They rallied around Meghan, countering the false narratives with their personal experiences of her character. This support is a testament to Meghan's positive impact on those she's worked with. If Meghan didn't have such a commendable track record, it might have been easier for the negative stories to gain traction. But her history of professionalism and kindness made these smear attempts seem far less credible. Her past, marked by a career devoid of any bullying accusations, has led people to question and often disbelieve the negative portrayals pushed by some media outlets. This dynamic is crucial to understand because it's not just about the present narratives, it's about the foundation on which these narratives are built. Now, let's consider Archie and Lilibet Diana. If Harry and Meghan continue to fiercely protect their privacy, as they are doing now, it's less likely that the media will succeed in any negative portrayal of them. And even if attempts are made to smear Archie and Lilibet in the future, the public may be skeptical of such claims, given the history of unfounded attacks against their mother. The key takeaway here is the power of a solid, positive history and the protective shield it offers against unfounded attacks. This is a crucial aspect of Harry and Meghan's approach to handling media narratives and safeguarding their family's privacy and reputation. As we watch these stories unfold, it's important to remember the context and history that inform them. Stay with us for more insights into the ongoing saga of the Sussex family and their interactions with the media. The narrative around Archie and Lilibet Diana being shaped by the UK public press is a concern for many. The fear is that these two young children, growing up far away from the royal spotlight in California, could be cast into roles they never asked for. Specifically, there's worry that they might be unfairly portrayed as scapegoats for William and Kate's kids. This is a scenario no one would wish for, especially not Harry and Meghan, who want their children to be happy, to thrive, and to understand their heritage, but certainly not to become pawns in a media-created rivalry. Harry and Meghan are doing an admirable job in protecting their kids' privacy. They're ensuring that no one can falsely claim to know Archie or Lilibet. This level of privacy shields their children from being mischaracterized by the media. We do hear occasional comments from those close to Harry and Meghan. For instance, someone mentioned that Archie is a well-mannered little boy. Harry himself has emphasized the importance of manners, saying, "Manners make the man." During the Invictus Games in the Netherlands, these snippets provide a glimpse into the values Harry and Meghan are instilling in their children, raising them to be respectful and well-mannered individuals. It's heartening to know these small positive details about Archie and Lilibet's upbringing. However, it's crucial to stay vigilant about the narrative spun by the media. The focus on their privacy and upbringing away from the media's glare is essential in allowing them to grow up as normal kids, not as characters in a royal drama scripted by the press. As we continue to follow their story, it's important to differentiate between what's genuinely known about them and what's merely speculation or fabrication by the media. Stay with us for more insights and updates on this ongoing story. The UK media's relationship with Archie and Lilibet is fraught with complexity and contradiction. Despite their eagerness to cover every aspect of Harry and Meghan's lives, they haven't had any real access to the couple's children. This lack of access is critical because it means that any narrative the media constructs about Archie and Lilibet is based on speculation rather than fact. There's a real concern that if the media were granted access, their coverage might not be favorable, particularly due to the children's mixed-race heritage. This is a sad reflection of the biases that still exist in parts of the media landscape. Harry has never expressed a desire for Archie and Lilibet to be exposed to the UK press. In fact, he and Meghan have gone to great lengths to protect their children from such exposure. Yet, there's this persistent notion in the media that if Charles, as their grandfather, has access to the children, the press should too. This sense of entitlement is problematic and ignores Harry and Meghan's wishes as parents. The UK media's self-perception is quite telling. They often act as if they're an extension of the monarchy or even on the same level. This attitude is evident in how they cover royal affairs, asserting a sense of entitlement to every aspect of the royals' lives, including those of Harry, Meghan, Archie, and Lilibet. Despite Harry suing them for phone hacking, you can see this almost desperate hope on TV that Harry might return to the royal fold. It's a bizarre situation. On one hand, they're being sued for invasion of privacy, and on the other, they're publicly longing for his return. This begging on TV comes across as both unsettling and revealing of the media's deep-seated fixation with the royal family. As we continue to explore this narrative, it's essential to keep in mind the delicate balance between public interest and the privacy rights of individuals, especially young children like Archie and Lilibet. Stay with us for more insights into this ongoing saga of privacy, media, and royalty. The UK media's fixation on having access to Prince Harry and Meghan Markle is a tale of unrequited interest, particularly with Prince Harry.